Hello everyone, this is Manisa Priya here from The Craft Shop, and today we are going to talk about various alcohol ink techniques. So I'm using Shilpi alcohol inks. I'm taking two colors of them, and then I have some Ranger alcohol inks. I'm going to demonstrate over a ceramic surface as well as on an acrylic surface. So these ceramic bases are available with The Craft Shop. There are a lot of shapes. This one is a kettle, it's in porcelain, and these are some acrylic circle coasters that I'm using to just demonstrate various techniques. So you can use any non-porous surface to use alcohol inks so that they don't get absorbed. This is isopropyl alcohol, that is 99% pure alcohol that we are going to use as a blending solution for alcohol inks. I'm just pouring it quickly into a spray bottle so that it would be easy and quick to use. So I've poured it into the shaker bottle and then quickly spraying some alcohol onto the surface just to prepare my surface. And now we'll be using some Ranger alcohol inks as well as Shilpi alcohol inks. Both of them are available with The Craft Shop. The beautiful range of colors that are there. So I'm picking some bright purples, yellows, reds and greens. So let's see how this goes. My first technique, I've sprayed some isopropyl alcohol onto the surface, and now I'm carefully dropping some ink onto the surface. Now you can use a heat tool to quickly dry the things, because since we are demonstrating here, I'm using a heat tool, or they dry out pretty quick naturally as well. So once I've applied the color, I'm just quickly spraying some alcohol onto the surface to just dilute my color. And you can use a brush to, you know, give the shape to your art form. Usually alcohol inks are very unpredictable and they take various shapes, but then you can just use some kind of brush, or you can use your earbuds that we use with little cotton swabs, that those also can be used. So I'm just taking out the excess onto the palette and trying to adjust the shape of my artwork. So I'm drying it with a heat tool here. Now I'm adding the second layer of color. You can see how beautiful the color spreads and gives out a natural shape. You just need to play with colors here. The more the layers, the more the rings and patterns that form. So just go around and, you know, play with the alcohol inks. They're so satisfying to work with. Also, they give out pretty bright patterns. You can make a lot of abstracts with them, and they look wonderful. In no time you can create a quick abstract for your wall. And now, to give it a little nebula kind of effect, I'm just spraying some more pure alcohol onto it just to add some splatters here and there, and this is done. You can imagine how this would look on a larger canvas. You know, any non-porous surface here can work. So for the second pattern, I'm just adding some large drops of purple here. This is in the color Karvanda from Shilpi Inks. And now I'm adding some isopropyl alcohol and then drying out my first layer. Now I'm beginning to add some layers to this, one after the other, and then drying each layer before I add another drop of alcohol ink. You can see how beautiful the patterns are coming out to be. I'm planning to, you know, make some monkey flowers here. Let's see how that goes. So yeah, I'm kind of satisfied with how my base color is. These inks have a pointed surface so that you can just play around and move the ink right with that pin. They give absolutely crisp images and lines. So yeah, you can do that as well. Like I said, alcohol inks are so easy to work with given the right technique. And then you just need to play around to get the design that you want. So I'm satisfied with the base coat. Now I'm adding the center yellows. I'm planning to make monkey flowers like I told you. So there we have it, the center yellows. And then I'll add some more purple to make it flower like. I'm quickly drying the colors here. And later I'll add the stems and stamp the leaves. So for the third one, I'm just planning to, you know, make a mixed media kind of project. I'm adding the color red from Ranger Inks. I'm adding a lot of it and then moving the color around and drying it out. I'll be repeating the process of adding the color just to add more layers to it. You can see how the edges are, you know, giving those patterns. This is the beauty of alcohol inks. You can achieve a similar kind of pattern with watercolors as well, but alcohol inks gives instant and bright results over any non-porous surface. Non-porous surface meaning anything that doesn't take the inks inside, it doesn't absorb the inks, like plastics, metal, you know, things like wood, paper, they absorb things. So things like acrylic, metal, ceramics, all these are good. And then once you are done with your artwork, you can either fire it up or you can add varnish, spray varnish, and then protect it. So I'm trying to move my ink a little using a brush. I'm happy with how it looked. Now I'm adding the second color, yellow. And then blending it together. Using the pointy tool, a drip tool, I'm just, you know, correcting the shape of my alcohol ink image. These inks have a pointy tool so you can, you know, make fine details onto the surface. I'm just adding random dots here and there. Just some splatters to add in some interest. And now I'm applying some isopropyl alcohol for the colors to move. This helps in diluting the color as well as easy movement. So it's always handy to have some blending solution that is isopropyl alcohol here. So now once everything is dry, I'm trying to do a little mixed media here with this pattern. So I'm taking some archival inks and little stamps. These are photopolymer stamps. You get it at the craft shop. So just stamp out the images. Use permanent inks in this case so that they wouldn't get removed. You can use Stazon, you can use archival ink or any other permanent ink that stays. on any surface. All of the inks and stamps are also available at the craft shop. Now for the other one, I'm just adding little dots. So now, just to add in some interest, I'm taking one more color that's in the color green and adding little leaves here and there. This is purely experimental and you can just play around with colors and designs and patterns however you like it. Alcohol inks are so good for any kind of artist. I'm just going around with a little color all over the edges so that it looks much brighter. You know, you need not be a pro to just play around with alcohol inks, and then you can create beautiful art for your home or for any space. Now going ahead with the last technique. Now I'm using a ceramic base. This is a beautiful jug with a lid. These are available with the craft shop. What I'm doing here is taking a cling wrap. You can use any kind of plastic here. Cling wrap holds better, so I'm just taking it and adding colors randomly. Pick and choose the colors that go well together according to the color wheel so that they do not blend into each other and make a muddy look. I'm taking the colors to give it a little ceramic fired glass look. So I'm just adding color onto this. Isn't it beautiful? The colors blend so well with each other and they give it that fox ceramic glazed kind of effect to your project. You can see how beautiful they blend in and give the look. You can keep adding more colors to it. Now for the base, instead of the cling wrap, I'm using a bubble wrap. The texture is on the other side. I'm just crunching the plastic together and then adding the inks onto the sheet. Now place your surface and then hold it together. Put all the plastic around it and make sure everything is covered properly the way you want it. Hold it for some time so that the ink transfers onto the ceramic base, and then hold tap it so that everything is nice and intact. This is something that is very interesting to play around. You can create random patterns and then they blend so well together. Look at how this is looking. The jar looks super awesome. This is an alternative to the drip technique that everybody follows, just dripping the color onto the surface, but this has more control and blending, I feel. So this gives the watercolor kind of effect as well. I hope you quickly enjoyed watching this tutorial. If you are wanting to find any products, they're all available with the craft shop. So this is how the jug looks after the lid. And these are the projects that we did today. If you have any questions, please write down in the comments below and I'd be happy to answer them all for you. I hope you enjoyed watching this quick tutorial on how to use alcohol inks and the various techniques that you can adopt. Thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe to our channel and then please like and comment if you are interested. Thank you so much for watching. This is Mansa here from Craft Shop signing off.